Mr. Morris. Oh, hello, Mr. Morris.
How are you?
I'm all right. I've got a fan going because it's hot to cool me down. you gotta get a straw hat to cover like a sombrero. Yeah, no, it's hot, man. I got the fan going in here. Shit.
Oh, that's I'm talking to one of my relations.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
So
yeah.
I'm gonna get a
head
full of what's taking place and what's happening.
Yeah, yeah. So you're picking up on how things are gonna pan out.
I heard Tony on the radio station this morning.
I did too. I did too. Out of six Ropus, there's only two or three left. And Pony's starting his own one up. But, you know. Yeah, well, that's what I told him. You're going to do your own. He's cheeky, all right, because that's what he said to me. He said, oh, you won't be talking like that in Mangamuka. But the way I was talking, and that's where the conversation ended. No, you can do it without all the rest. Manahi will cover you, because he'll.
No, I'm gonna get on there.
Yeah. Yeah. So,
Honor will be a chicken black bastard.
Yeah.
He knows me.
Yeah.
He fucking dare talk to me like that.
Yeah, but I spoke to Manahi, and I told Manahi that Hayward hijacked the Ratana church, your house church, and you know why they left it dilapidated like that in the memorial? So they've taken that title, and he's using it for their own titles with Peter Paroni. He's there for the crown and themselves. And Manahi's shocked.
I'm trying to understand, but more of it's so cruel to me.
Yeah, well, that's true.
You know, I can't snap it up straight away like others.
Yeah.
But, you know, when I've been listening to you talking to you,
yeah.
Yeah. A bit more to, I can really.
Yeah.
So, I don't want to go talking to people.
No.
I had
it out with Bundy last night. There was a heated bloody talk with him, and he just kept. It was a heated talk with him. And it went on and on. He said, John, it's not about the money. We only want the land back. I said, well, Bundy, you'll have to get everybody off the land if you want it back. But it's about the money. He's not saying. He just said, I said, Bundy, you're using the flag for some other reason than what it's supposed to be. And he said, the Treaty of Waitangi wasn't signed where you're saying it is it's signed at Titi. And I said, well, that's your story. You can keep that. But I say that it's like this. The simplest way to put it is like this. The boat sails in from Britain and heads into Hokianga Harbour. And it stops on Tahike land. And it sets itself up and it talks to Hori Tikuri. And says, right, Hori Tikuri, we make a deal. We'll buy the land off you and make the deal here in this mission house. And it's a private sale and purchase, straight to the king, because these lands are already sold and we have come here with a title. And that's what I'm talking about with your title. It's none of anybody's business whether the treaty was signed there or signed at Waitangi. Your treaty was signed inside that mission house on your land, and Manahi's there to say so, and my friend Moira Hoffman Russell from the Russell family and the Busby family settled on your land at Whirinaki, Hori Tikuri's land, and bought the land from Hori Tikuri and Rāmeka. And that's the end of it. Nobody can argue with that. That's none of their business. You see? And that was in the time of that flag. And Bundy says, oh, the flag is not for the reasons that he's using it for. He's using it for their sovereignty. I said, you got your own sovereignty and your own flag. You didn't need this flag because it's not there for you to wave around. It's a bank trading flag. You're supposed to be using it for trading. You see, he's cunning. He's cunning to make another story up that there's no connection with Britain there. The connection with Britain is over in Titi. Well, the proof is in the pudding, Morris. Those Russells and the Busbys have bought land over there in Whirinaki before they bought more land on the other side in Russell. They bought the land under that contract inside that Whirinaki mission house and the church there, the Methodist church there, and connected to that referefa title in Auckland and the native court there in Tāheke. There, that's how it happened. The native of Hori in his marae connected to those British that he let settle on his Tāheke land. And all of that Tāheke land is 360, right around Whirinaki and all those places, where those British put their house up and started living on there first before they went over to Russell. Those British decided, no trade over here, there's more trade on the other side of Kororareka. So they upped camp, left everything there with their titles, then went around in a ship on the other side and parked themselves as a second Russell family settlement, right? You get that?